there's the chocolate lab from a Google search. It's warm sitting right by the radiator. I don't know why I was so cold. So I switched on all the heating available for about half an hour. Now it's getting pretty toasty. So, how does that affect what you're seeing? That's pretty good. Fear of painting. Is my water. I've got three pinks here to choose from, and I didn't do the swatches very well, so I can't really tell the difference between them, although this one sure catches my eye the most, because it's the most easily wet. And I have, well, I don't know what paint it is. I do have an idea of what it could be, but I don't know for sure what paint it is. It could be Daniel Smith, one of two types of Daniel Smith. It could be Core, I think it's called, Q-O-R. Mm-hmm. fun when it's easy like this. Just a pale pink and doing large swaths of it. There's not that much risk of committing an atrocious error. If you could see the reference photo, you might see what I mean. But I do still, I have fears about doing around those little nostrils because I'm afraid the black paint on them will run when I put pink around them. And I think I'm gonna try and put pink around them just about now. Maybe I should wait because it's hard to explain in words. It means I've got a brush full of paint that I'm wasting though, and I hate wasting paint, so just. Hope for the best. Don't run black paint. Yeah, this is pretty easy sailing. Compared to how it usually feels painting. Or how, yeah, usually. I think somebody on Solo pointed out morrisseysolo.com. Pointed out that I tend to stress out, that's, I think was the words, when it comes to the majority of another painting I did. Whereas I relaxed when I painted the cup. The cup in the painting. Well, wow. there's more pink involved, but I'm afraid I'll lose my way if I paint it in right now. It's hard to explain. I'm scared. Scared of screwing up. So maybe some gray now. Which brush though? I can use this one, or this one, or this one. I'm gonna try this one. A gray. Well, this is a gray. I mean, this will be gray when it's diluted. See how stingy I am with paint? I don't go for the fresh paint. I'm using the leftovers. But it's probably too dark. I don't know. I'll use a test paper. Yeah. Too dark. Drop some water in there. Test the scrap paper again. It's still too dark. This stuff is powerful. This is, I think this is the color called Jane's Gray by Daniel Smith. Yeah, it's still too dark. Okay, it's getting closer, but still dark. I don't know if you can see that on camera. This is the test paper. I'm going lighter and lighter as I add more water to this paint. You can hardly call it paint. It's water with a little bit of pigment in there. More water. Okay, that's about the color I'm going for. Hope I'm right. So, gray. Gray areas are, well, some anyway are, oh geez, the sketch is wrong, or I didn't finish it and I can't figure out, uh-oh, oh boy, I hope this is right. Way too much water. Way, way too much water. Oh. And the paint turns out to be way too thin. Okay, start off with fresh paint, then. And a smaller brush, because my confidence is just taking a blow. Jane's Gray of Everything's in the Way here. The tripod stand is in the way, and my tablet is in the way. This is Jane's Gray. Water. Too much water, though, I think. It's really hard to judge. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. And this paper swatch, or I mean this paper, scrap paper, is a very different ground than this watercolor ground. So, geez, it's very confusing. I don't know what I'm doing. See, that works on the paper, but the paper absorbs it, but you can't leave a puddle without getting hard marks, can you? I don't want hard marks. And I should have let that area dry before applying more paint. Entirely know. I know a little bit. I know I should add that to that because it's too pale. I'm not even sure if I'm judging how pale this paint should be. I hope I'm doing it right. I'm liking this watercolor ground. I don't know what it's made of though. I don't know. I don't. It's probably not vegan, or it would have said so on the bottle. It didn't. But I got it for free. But I would have bought more if they wouldn't have given me a second bottle free, because one bottle was not thick enough, a coat. One thing about this gray is it's gonna be very forgiving because it's so light, if I am making a mistake. No, tablet, do not close on me. People say you should sand this watercolor ground, but I hate the idea of sanding it. It just makes me cringe. And I know that people probably won't watch this video. I've noticed, I notice in how many views I get, not many. But yeah, most of the views are me watching it. It helps me to feel less alone to watch my own videos. And it's self-knowledge. I'm just guessing at what I'm doing here. Heck. I'm screwing up. I can see that now. But doing this gray, because it's so forgiving, it's allowing me to get a feel for this. The layout of this dog. Yeah, I could have used the big brush. These swaths of gray. I guess I'll try using the bigger brush. Excuse me. Let's broccoli with peanut butter dip that you just heard. Oh, no, I don't want to add more water. This brush holds a lot of water. Why don't I just cover the whole thing in gray? Because I'm a chicken shit. Because I. Well, just because of the wonderful thing she does. I'm off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Yeah, anybody who watches this video has got time on their hands and patience. That would be me. Well, I have patience when it comes to watching my own videos. Videos of my own voice and hands. too much water, it's going to turn into a hard line because it's a puddle. Let's see if I can do something about that. I guess this will be okay. I don't know. In case you're wondering what song I'm singing, it is Morrissey. You were good in your time. You know, the pigment is settling into the grooves of the wood there. I don't know if I want that to happen. Could be a good effect, but it could be a bad effect too. Hot. No, I put in this sketch, oh my god, I got it so wrong. Uh-oh, I got it really wrong. Sketch on the fly here. Oh boy, did I ever screw that up? Tablet, don't close. Because that's a paw, that's a leg, there's another leg. Oh my god. So screwed up. This gray, I'm using it the wrong way. It's hard to explain. I think I might be able to get away with yikes, doing it on the fly like this. Rivka told me. Rivka of MorrisseySolo.com told me to do my sketches, take the time to do your sketches properly. Well, I have trouble heeding that advice, clearly. Well, some people would call me a spoiled child, but I don't think it's quite that simple. Okay, my ego or my confidence or something is shaken now because of recognizing that big mistake with the sketch. Although it looks like it's gonna be okay. I wanna pack it in now, just step back and regroup. Watch this video, see if I can get any insight into what I just did. Oh my God. Okay. Well, I know that I have it good. Don't you worry. If this is my adventure, this is my calamity, and this is where I get my fears from, I know I have it lucky. So, signing off.